श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुः साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे One lady once upon a time met me in Bombay and she said, Swamiji, I am always confused with you. I said, that is not your fault because I am like that. Do you know what confusion I have? I said, no, I don't know and nor I want to know. Keep it with you. No, I want to tell you. Sometime I feel you are my brother. Sometime I feel you are my father. Sometime I feel you are my friend. I don't know what should I call you. Because I love you so much, I get confused. Then I told her, I said, look here. Pyar ko pyar hi rehne do, rishto ke naam na do. See? Whenever love is reduced, in relationship, attachments and the subsequent problems begin. See, friends, like yesterday we were somewhere, I was talking one verse of Bhagavan Shankaracharya. Vishwam pashyati karya karanataya swaswami sambandataha shishyacharyataya tathaiva pitruputradhyatmana bhedataha. स्वप्ने जागृति वाय एष पुरुषः माया परिभ्रामितः तस्मै श्री गुरुमूर्तये नमः इदं श्री दक्षिणामूर्तये. द वर्ल्ड बिगिन्स द मोमेंट कॉज एंड इफेक्ट बिकम्स द फाउंडेशन ऑफ आवर लाइफ. हाउ इट बिकम्स? बाय क्रिएटिंग टू प्रॉब्लम्स इन आवर लाइफ. वन प्रॉब्लम इज the problem of possessiveness and second is the problem of relationships. So swaswami sambandataha, we become swami and subordinate, subordinate and swami, or shishyacharya, one becomes guru, other becomes shishya, and both of them suffer. And the third, पितृपुत्राद्यात्मना भेदतः, we create relations, mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, blah, 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 blah. And in this world, who is miserable is these illusory personalities called as mother, father, husband, wife, sister, etc. See? So let them remain only a particular level, and that's it. Let us not carry the burden of this on our head throughout life. So, let us understand it. I, as a man, become divided into many fractions only on account of the relations. So I become son, I become husband, I become father, I become father-in-law, I become son-in-law. And if we just find out deep in ourselves, who is miserable? It is the son, the husband, the father, the in-law, the outlaw. These are the one who are miserable. So what do we do then? Become Babaji? Don't take my market away. Don't become Babaji. Then play your role. See, all the problems of relative world can be dissolved only by one technique. And that one technique is play the game of life. See? You know, we have got two principles in our scriptures. According to that, what is this world? Oh, it is Ram Leela, it is Krishna Leela. See, Ram Leela or Krishna Leela means what? Leela means a drama. What is a drama? Everything appears to be happening, but in fact, nothing is happening. See, on the stage, one boy comes, the hero, with a recyclable plastic flower. Honey, darling, without you, I cannot even live. He is addressing it to the flower, but that fool understands that he is talking to her. These are only the dialogues. And she also says, there is none like you who could love me. And then a curtain falls. Thereafter, they never even look at each other. Then what was happening on the stage? Only acting. Now go within yourself. Do we act in our life or we react in our life? Whenever there are relations, relational interactions are reactions. A child is not studying. आजकल के बच्चे ऐसे ही होते हैं. But if it is my son not studying, then the heaven falls down. One mother somewhere in Bombay came to me. Swami, the world is very bad. I said, what do I do now? I'll try to improve upon it. You know why? Because my neighbor gave me sweets in the morning. So I kept quiet. When somebody gives you sweet, the world is bad. There is no connection, you know. I thought she may be derailed and therefore came to a wrong number. You know why? Because her son got into merit list. So I kept quiet. So I said, yes, very good. She has got her son in merit list, she will give, I will also do the same thing. No, you don't understand. Only to tell this you have come to me. Then she says that, why my son is failing for 4 years continuously? Now see, child failing in examination is not the issue. Issue is my son is failing. So my son is the relationship. So what is the rule? The rule is, in the relative world, there is no solution to any problem. This world has always been like this. And because of children, nobody has become happy till date. See, my observations and conclusions are totally different. If you study Ramayana, I don't know what you learn from Ramayana. Once, you know, in Melbourne, Ramesh Bhai Oja came and I was also called there for giving a talk for 10 minutes. So he was talking on Ramayana. Now he is a great, speaker with lot of music and lot of followers, you know. There are two types of Mahatmas. One is a Pendal brand, second is a Hall brand. I am a Hall brand Mahatma. Those who are Pendal brand, they have got a huge, you know, orchestra and everything. So there I told that in Ramayana, I don't know what you learned, but what I learned is this, that even Bhagwan Ram is your son, Dashratha died because of Rama. See? Vasudev, Devaki, they were in the jail because of Krishna. So when Sakshat Bhagwan is the child, this is the fate of the parents. With our kabutars, what do you expect? But we get so disgusted. Look within. We are simultaneously children to our parents and parents to our children. We are not disturbed with reference to our parents. And we are not at peace with reference to our children. We are the same. So who is disturbed? It is not me as a mother, me as a woman or a man. It is the mother or the father or the son or the daughter. See, friends. Therefore, it is necessary for us to know we play our role up to a particular limit and beyond that, bye-bye. See? And people stay together never because of love. Then, because of understanding. This is okay, a good dialogue in the Hindi movie. Main tumse pyar karta hoon. तुम्हारे लिए आसमान के तारे तोड़ के ला सकता हूं लेकिन रखोगी कहां Therefore I cancelled. It is okay in the movie, but people stay together not because of love, because of understanding. Now, what relationships lead to? Relationships lead to some kind of expectations, mutual expectations. See? Is it not that I have little right on my wife? Is it not I have got little right on my children? See? Whenever we speak about rights, we are wrong. See, friends, one thumb rule I'll tell you, try it. Write off your rights right away, or else they'll perform our rights right away. No right on anybody in this world. This principle I discovered, there was one girl, she was supposed to come with me to Uganda. So I said, hey, you get your passport done. So there was one person and he said, Swamiji, I'll help her. I said, okay, hang on him, he'll get it done. Now that poor girl, every time going to that man, once, twice, thrice, four, five times, 1 month gone. And one day she came frustrated. Swamiji, that man told everybody, he never does anything, he made me go 10 times and nothing is happening, he's very bad. I said, cool, first of all. Now, first of all, find out what right you and me have on him. Do you have any right? No. Then, on what authority you say that he should have done that? So, what is the cause of misery? That we exercise rights on others. See, and our condition is like what? I am victim of my mind, he is victim of his mind. So one victim is trying to control the other victim and both are victimized. Therefore, the moment relationships are established, expectations are born. And wherever there are expectations, there is bound to be frustration. So to live in relation, this is the first thumb rule. Write off your rights. Now there are four types of relations that we all have to live through. First relation is relation with our elders. See. Now I'll tell you an example. There is one couple. About 8 or 9 years they were married. No child. And when I met for the first time that girl, she came for my lecture somewhere. When she came, I started talking to her in her mother tongue. She doesn't look at all like that. She looks as if an imported model. So when I spoke to her in her mother tongue, she said, how come you know this is my mother tongue? I said, don't go further. Now tell me. How are you? Everything is fine. Slowly they became close. Then after 2-3 days, Swamiji, आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू, आई हैव बीन हियरिंग यू सो मेनी ईयर्स, नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू टॉक टू यू. शुरू हो जाओ. मी एंड माई हजबेंड वी आर कॉन्स्टेंटली फाइटिंग. आई सेड टेल समथिंग न्यू. What is there to tell? Me and my husband, husbands and wives are meant for legal partners to fight. See? You can continue. Kal kahan choda tha? Continue like a serial. Wherever you left from, there you start. No, Swamiji, I don't know why this is happening and all. I said, look here. I have got two principles when I talk to somebody. Principle number one, no discussions. Principle number two, no arguments. Then I'll talk. Okay. I said, how do you address your husband? Abhijit, jara wo jhadu laga dena. When you start addressing your husband by his name, you can never respect him. I said, in your own tradition, husbands are called as indirectly. Like, you know, in our UP, I am from UP. In our UP, the husbands are addressed as AG. And one person asked me, Swamiji, ye AG kya hota hai? What is this AG? I said, look here, our Indian ladies are, you know, very decent, cultured. Therefore, they don't call names to their husband in public. Then they have abbreviated it. What is that? AG is A Gade. So nobody knows it. The respect is given. See, all ladies are feeling fulfilled. And actually they are really like that, or else who will marry all these ladies unless they are gades. Okay. I said, you stop calling him by name, call him as per your tradition indirectly, and then see what happens. And she started. Within a period of few months, again she happened to talk to me on phone. I said, hey, kaise chal raha hai? How are you? Swamiji, I don't know what is that, but there is a change in our relationship, and that, you know, jhagda, tutu, mai mai is reduced. Friends, whenever we address anybody respectfully, we cannot lose our tongue. The fundamental rule of life. See, suppose I call him as Mahatma Ji, as I call everybody, Mahatma Ji. After that, can I abuse him? Mahatma Ji, ye kaise lagaunga? You cannot say. You cannot say. See? And if you call somebody by a loose word, are beyakoof, I see, immediately it comes. Therefore, to establish healthy and lasting relations, first and the most important thing is we must learn to respect the person to whom we are talking. Disrespectfully, the moment we start, our relations are bound to end up in bitterness. See, friends. Otherwise, you see, we all go to temples or bring idols and keep in the house. See? Once I went to Jaipur, and I like seeing the things. Rather than going to temples, I like to see the shopping malls, movie theaters, something different, because I live in the present, I don't live in the past. So I said, hey, let's go to see various, you know, the murtis, idols in Jaipur. There's a big market. So we went. When we went there, one shopkeeper came down. Maharaj ji, aiye, please come. See, this Krishna is so beautifully done. It was so nice. It has inspired me. And last night I had a dream from the same Krishna that tomorrow such and such Mahatma is coming. Give me to him. I said, oh, thank you so much, Krishna. I told my friend, I said, be uthao. He said, Swamiji, for others it would have been 51,000. But for you, because Lord Himself told me, 21,000. 30,000. I said, I didn't want to tell you, but now because you told me, I'll tell you. What? The same Krishna came in my dream also. And he told me that this person who has produced me, he will ask you this much. Don't give him that much. Then give him 2100. No. He said, Nene Swamiji, mazak kar rahe. I said, no, I am not mazaking. See, am I challenging your dream? I am not challenging. So how can you challenge my dream? And then I buy that Krishna for 2100, which was 51,000, can reduce it. And then put it in the puja room. Then after that, Tvameva Mata Chapita Tvameva Tvameva Vandushta Saka Tvameva. Hey Bhagavan, I have purchased a lottery ticket. I should get $250 million. Bhagavan says, Mujhe bhav karke khirid ke laya. You purchase me bargaining for the cost and you want this much. Don't we do this? See friends, when we were buying that idol, that time there was no respect and reverence. It was a matter of buying a good. After it is installed in the temple, immediately the attitude changes and we have respect and reverence. Friends, when we give respect and reverence to a stone idol, the stone idol is not benefited. It is we who are benefited. This is the foundation of healthy relationship. We must have respect. See? And with this respect, with elders when we live, that is called as pure love. If we have got any expectations, then we are going the wrong way. Elders are meant only to respect those unfortunate ones who do not have elders in their lives. They are the most poor people in the whole world. We have to have an altar, better a living altar, before whom we surrender, we don't argue, and we submit ourselves. That is the only way our intellect can be subdued, can be quietened, and we transcend the limitations of cause and effect. Otherwise, what human intellect does, tries to establish cause and effect. And thereafter, whatever has been beneficial to me, to that cause I am attached. And whatever has been detrimental to me, to that cause I hate. The net result is, every interaction in my life goes on precipitating likes and dislikes on my mind. And this is where we start our samsara. So, interact in this world in such a manner that our mind remains untouched by the interaction like the mirror. See, one day in England, somewhere they took me to an old cathedral which was burned away and all kind of. So, when I was seeing those things, on some wall corner, there was one small mirror which was fixed in the wall. So, I was standing looking at it. So, my friend asked me, Swamiji, what are you looking? I said, I am trying to see how many people must have looked into this mirror, whether there is any account or not? Swami, what are you talking? I said, no, I'm just seeing whether I can find out how many people have looked into the mirror. It's not possible, because mirror does not have the past. Mirror always lives in the present. Relationships are nothing but the load of the past, to such an extent that under that load and the covering of the past, our present is clouded, our present is covered. See? Therefore, come this side. Put ke aao. Giso mat. So, when we are thus aware of the relations in such a manner, are these relations creating dents on our mind, or these relations are keeping our mind uninfluenced, untouched by them? This is what has to be taken into account when relationships are handled. One of the most important things. See, one girl in Vrindavan asked me this question. Swamiji, can you tell me, how do I know whether I am walking the spiritual path in the right direction or I am getting lost? I said, don't ask anybody, not even me. You find out in your own heart. Your mind is at peace or not? Number two, do you talk to yourself too much? The more we talk to ourselves, we are not at peace with ourselves. We keep on talking. Only observe this one. Then you will come to know that we talk to the relations which we have created. If he says like that, I say like that. So see that we talk minimum to ourselves. Then relations are not influencing us. Please come and sit on the thing. It is cold there. I am feeling cold from below. Good. So, whenever we are having any kind of relationship with anyone, see that no impressions are made on the mind. Now be very attentive. Then what happens? Every moment we are present fully. For example, suppose I look at Amma. Now, instead of looking at her and talking about her, if I am reminded of my relationship, my mother also looks like that, where she must be now, see, what she must be doing. So what will happen? I may be in front of her, but I am not with her. And she can immediately catch, we all can catch it. When somebody is talking to us, interacting, we know that this fellow is not with us. On the contrary, if we are able to interact in such a manner that we do not create any impressions, relations, etc., in such a manner that we carry that load with us, then we are able to remain 100% in the present. And when we are 100% in the present, that experience is called as God realization. Don't have misgivings about God realization. In the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna defines God realization. Shitoshna sukhadukheshu jitatmanaha, number one. And manapamanayoho prashantasya, number two. Paramatma samahitaha. Paramatma samahitaha, One is in tune, merge in the divine. If these two things are happening, number one, Shita Ushna Sukadukeshu Jitatmana. He whose mind remains untouched by all kinds of experiences in life, and his equanimity doesn't get contaminated by any experience. Bad experiences create agitations. Good experiences create expectations. Agitations and expectations are the impurities of the mind. See? Then the second thing, manapamanayoho prashantasya. We have some image about ourselves. Similarly, people also have image about us. When our image about us and people have image about us, when these two images have a parallax, when they don't match, then the samsara begins. See, friends, therefore, in any relationship that we have to live, this is the first principle. We have the foundation of our relationship with the elders with that of respectful reference. But you know, some old people in our house are so terrible, what can be done with them? I'll tell you one experience. I must have told some other reference. This happened in Bombay. In Bombay, you know, people live in small houses like matchboxes. And there is to be one person, his wife and one child. That man is to come for my lectures. Wife never came. And one day she came and she said, "You have spoiled my husband." I said, "Now you come, I'll spoil you also." What else can I do? Then she told her story. He is such a person that he is not taking any interest in the house. I said, "You are taking interest, good. Men should not take interest in the kitchen. Those houses where men take interest in the kitchen, those ladies are most miserable, you know. All the time, kya bana hai? Kaise bana hai? Tumhare sar ka bheja bana hai." So, you know, my mother-in-law, I said, "I understood the whole problem." She said, "We have got only 1.5 room. Front room is about 12 by 10 and the back room is about 10 by 8. And in the back room, we have kitchen, we have our bedroom, there my son studies, and there in the corner we have got bathroom. And in the front room, this old lady, her own space, doesn't allow anybody to use that room. And my husband doesn't tell her anything." I said, "Then why do you stay separately?" "No, that we cannot do, because when she will die, she will not give this house to us." Oh, I said, "Now I understood the problem. What is that? Why don't you kill her?" No, how can I kill her like that? I said, "You are a good lady, therefore you can't kill. Why don't you tell your husband to kill his mother?" "Swamiji, why are you after killing her?" I said, "No, these are the options we are thinking, you know. In software, you think only about options, do nothing." See? Then I said, "Okay, you want me to do the job? Give me one supari. I can finish that job." No, not killing her. I said, "Look here, Mama, I'll tell you something. Don't tell anybody. If you will tell, it will be applied on you." "What is that?" I said, "Come near." In her ear I told. After 287 days, she is going to die. Your mother-in-law is going to die after 287 days. Then, whenever there is katkut, simply count 280. Again, something 275. And see what happens. Really, I said, "Yes. But if you tell somebody, including your husband, it will be applied on you, okay? Okay, Swaja, I will not tell anybody. After 3-4 months, again she came. Swamiji, I want to talk to you. And my heart started coming out of the chest and going inside. Whether she really died. Or she didn't die. Because I don't remember how many days I told. Love, how can you remember? Truth, you can remember. Then she said, Swamiji, I want you to revert that thing, you know, what? She should not die. So why? Now I understood. That is her nature, to say no to everything, but afterwards she does. I was not able to understand her. She is not bad. Now I understood her. When she used to say no to something, I used to react. But now after you told this thing, when she'll say no something, I have to keep quiet. And then she'll come, okay, take this thing. But first time she has to say no. Because mother-in-law after all, there was a beggar like this house. He came and asked for food. So the daughter-in-law was at home. She said, no, no, go ahead. She was going. From that stage, the mother-in-law was coming from the temple and she saw, hey beggar, you went to that house, did you get anything? No, that lady didn't give me, she didn't give anything, come with me. So he was with hopes, he came. And after he came, she went inside. And from there she said, go ahead, I won't give anything. He said, the same lady said the same thing, why you are not telling something different? What is new about it? Who is she to say no? I will say no, not the daughter-in-law. He prays. Most of the time, our relations get spoiled because we immediately react. Just keep cool. And when we start keeping cool, then we start not reacting, but only acting. When it is only action without reaction, it is called as a response. Life has to be responsible, not reactionary. See? And on the stage, another principle. When we are, you know, seeing a drama, there are two parties. One party is the one which is acting on the stage. The second party is the audience. Never be an audience. Always be on the stage. On the stage, they are only acting. See, the actor comes. And the whole story is built up in such a manner that emotional upsurge has come in the whole audience. And then the actor is crying. And then the whole audience takes out the tissue paper and start crying with the nose. I don't know why in the recent days people have stopped crying by the eyes. They cry only by the nose. So they take out the tissue paper. Maybe the hole has increased. The lacrimal duct is, you know, bringing those things. That time what goes on in the mind of the actor on the stage? You fools, I am paid for fake crying. You are really paying and really crying. This is just a drama, re baba, drama, nothing real. Exactly the same way. When we start acting in life, no impression is made on the mind. Then what is acting? Whatever role we are supposed to play. If you are before the wife, behave properly. If you are in front of your subordinate, show that you are a man. What is it? It's just drama. Only act as if, no, now like this, you know, as if you are listening. The same technique. Technique we have. Only apply it in the right field. Then we will function in relations, but we will not be bound by relations. See? Therefore, what I said in the beginning, because of love, two people don't stay together. Because of understanding, people stay together. See? This love is the most confused word in the whole world. I love you. I love my dog. Therefore, I love you like a dog. No. Understanding is more important than love. So, with elders, relationship is only reverential relationship. And when we have somebody to respect and revere, before that alone, our intellect becomes quiet. One simple technique I'll tell you, which I follow in my life. Like in a take example here, our Swami Paramahansa Maharaj is there. So, when I come here, I don't think about anything, where I have to go, what program, etc. When I come here, my clothes, who will wash? I don't want to worry. I take it out, put it in there and wash. Somebody irons. Food, somebody cooks and gives me. How nice life is. Go one step further. Somebody thinks for you. You don't think. Remain a follower. See? What should we do this weekend? You tell, darling, you are a very good planner. Let us go for a movie. Yes, perfectly, all right. Very good, we'll go for a movie. Let him think, you just follow. Relax. No, but I was planning to go, you know, not for a movie, for a nice long track. What is there in the track? Keep on walking unnecessarily. Movie, at least have nice popcorn and watch. Then, on that issue, the jagada begins. See, one of the most important thing, when two persons are there, only one should be the leader, not both the leaders. And a wise one is always a follower. The other wise is the leader. See, look at India. No Indian citizen is worried. Leaders are fighting, and we watch from distance. And again, we give them voters. See, when in New Orleans, that tsunami came, Katrina, so much of destruction occurred, it took more than 1 year to get the thing sorted out. Same time, tsunami came in Bombay also. But everything was sorted out within 4 days, including electricity. How this could happen? Because in that country, they were waiting for the government to do something. In India, we know government does nothing. So we do ourselves. So when you live without expectation, your life is beautiful. And therefore, it is the simplest way. Remain as a follower. So where you have to go, what you have to do. Somebody is thinking, you relax. But don't destroy my camera. Don't relax too much. So, this is the relationship with elders, respectful, reverential attitude. And when we stop arguing, logic, reason, a huge burden is removed. Then we remain in the utter present. Otherwise, keep on worrying. I have to do this, I have to do this. Why relax? Relax. Then we have a second relationship with our contemporaries. See? The relationship with the contemporaries is only on the foundation of friendship. Who is a friend? A friend is accepted by the friend as he is. Then only the friendship can remain. We know what are the shortcomings of our friend, yet we trust. Friendship is not a bond of love, but it is an understanding of trust. I read one beautiful story. There was one, now this story is story, don't ask question on the story. There was a friend who was lying in the lap of his friend after lunch, and the friend was sitting, the other one. From that side a big cobra came and wanted to bite. So this friend said, please don't bite, my friend is sleeping. No, I want his blood, he has hurt. He said, okay, you want his blood, I'll give his blood, but don't bite him. He said, okay, give blood. So he took out his knife and cut a little bit near the throat, and some blood came out, and then he was giving. The snake took the blood, tasted and went away. Then this friend whose little bit of throat was cut to remove the blood, he said, when I was cutting your throat, didn't you feel insecure? He said, no, when the knife is in your hand, it cannot be anything but for my good. See, friendship is a bond of trust. With elders, it is a relationship of respect and reverence. Then there is no problem in life. See, there is one lady in India, she is the first chairperson of a bank, a national bank. And Mrs. Kumar, I still remember her. She was honored, civic honor was given, reception was given to her in Ahmedabad, and I was invited to honor her. So after, you know, the routine things, you know, giving the shawl and one coconut to eat in her house after taking chutney out of it. And then a lecture. So she gave a lecture. How her profession she continued and how she came to, you know, that position at a national level. And every now and then she was referring. This was all possible because of my husband supported me. Like that it continued. Then after everything was question answer, the people were not interested in her professional achievements. Their only concern was, how could you keep relationship with your husband so cool? What was the secret? And what she said was so beautiful. She said, when I got married, my mother told me one principle. Always remain one step behind the husband. You will be always happy in your life. And she said, this principle I have followed throughout my life in letter and spirit. My husband respects and reveres me like a goddess, but I never have taken any advantage. I have always remained as his follower and I have never disrespected him on any issue. This is how, you know, mutual relationship is built, and then only it lasts for a long time. Normally, in most of the places where the jagada happened, is only because tutu, mai mai tutu. I don't know where it is. Is it in Melbourne? We went to some Punjabi family for taking food. And that lady, she gave us all food. And then I said, Mama, you take food. So that old man, he says, Swamiji, no, you take. I have given up her. She doesn't listen. After we finish our food, when we are lifting the plate, no, don't do. See, I also don't lift. Because she doesn't like it. And I cannot do it. So after that, I ask her, I say, Mama, why this is so? He says, Swamiji, this is my vow. Unless everybody takes food at home, and I remove everything, and then I take food. Because of that small little thing, there is such a harmony in the house. Small little thing. Sacrifice. I said, but that was old thing. Swamiji, whatever is old or new, I am just obeying the orders of my mother. She has never taken food before her husband has taken. I follow the same rule. My husband is tired of me on this issue, but I don't listen. And that keeps me going. See, friends, wherever relationship with the elders, respectful, with the friends, trust. Then the third relationship we all have to go through is relationship with our youngsters, next generation. Youngsters are qualified and allowed to commit mistakes. Elders are supposed to forgive them. Such a simple rule. So love for the elders is reverence. Love for the contemporaries is friendship. Love for the youngsters is forgiveness. See, I'll tell you one example. This happened in Bombay. One very orthodox Brahmin family, and very nice, regularly coming for satsang and bring food for me, therefore they are good. So, one day when they got the food for me, both husband and wife, husband is retired probably and wife is working. You know, in a very deep, I said, Mama, today there is something wrong somewhere. What is this? You are not well. Why did you bring food? I would have taken from someone else. No, Swamiji, we wanted, therefore we said. What happened? You know, our daughter, I said, yes. She has found out a boy, not from our community. And, in our family, nobody has done like this thing. And we are so disturbed, we don't know what should we do and all that going on. So we want your advice. I said, again, you have come, two principles, no discussion, no argument. Yes, Swamiji, whatever you say, we'll do it. I said, first of all, get their marriage done respectfully and with all sincerity. Don't have any bitterness for any reason. And it will be the best time for you to enslave both your daughter and son-in-law for the whole life. Don't react. And see what happens. And then they got them married. After 2 years, again the other day, I said, hey, how is the couple going on? Swamiji, that boy is a gem of a boy. And the people in his house, they may not be very rich, but they have got great culture, mutual respect. And we are very happy that we got this marriage done. If they had reacted that time, if they had not forgiven their daughter, their whole life would have been a mess. Exactly opposite happened in the same city of Bombay. A friend of mine, he was in the film industry, writing lyrics and dialogues. And he is only son. He was, a CA, and he was in love with one Muslim girl. And that Muslim girl was so good. Bohra Muslims, they are different. They are not like the fanatic Muslims. So she came and stayed in their house for 1 month. And she said, I am ready to become Hindu because I have no full faith in everything. Everything was done. And this man came, he said, Swamiji, what should I do? I said, tell me, is she bad? No. Are any bad body? When you stay with somebody for 1 month, you know at least something, No, nothing. I said, then why don't you get married? Swamiji, what people will say? I told my son, no. I said, all right, then go ahead. Then my son has left for USA. By the same flight, that girl also went to USA. And they got married in USA. Both of them CA, highly educated. And in between, they said, father, Now they said son and they said husband. That lady was crushed in between the two. And when this happened, she had a brain hemorrhage and died. Then the same girl and the boy, they were called back. And then he said, I attended the whole thing. Then he said, Beta, now you are the Bahu of this house. You have to take care of everything. Had he accepted it earlier, a life would have been a dignified and beautiful. See, one of the most important things in life, we have to understand our youngsters, forgive them, and accept them as they are. See? But whenever the prestige issue comes, then all these problems come. See? So, with the elders, reverence, contemporaries, friendship, youngsters, forgiveness, and there are bad elements in the society. Even from the bad elements, we can learn. See, if we are the seekers of truth. The other day I was telling Subhashji, I received one SMS. All the wisdom in the world comes to me through SMS. God sends me SMS. One SMS was, politicians divide us, terrorists unite us. Commitment of the terrorists is more to their cause than the commitment of the politicians to the nation. We may condemn them. We are all doing that. But can we underestimate their commitment to the cause, whatever they have chosen? Instead of hating somebody, if we have this process of learning from everything in this world, then no good or bad relations will ever happen. In this manner, we all have to live in this relative world. And keeping these four principles in mind, if we live, life will be beautiful. And to sum up the whole thing, the best way I can say is, make life as a time pass. This is the principle of life. See, when we live life as a time pass, what exactly technically happens? See, when I say in English, it is taken as a joke. But when the same thing is said by some Mahatma in Sanskrit, it becomes wisdom. See? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was asked this question. Sir, why do you chant Lord's name? You are already established in the truth. Why do you chant Lord's name? He said, yeah, really, you are right. Why I am chanting Lord's name, I also don't know. But maybe a good time pass. He said it in Sanskrit. Kalakshepanartham. Kalakshepan means time pass. Live like a time pass. Now, what is the principle of time pass? See, one example will make it clear. When we are playing with the children, we are not concerned about winning or getting defeated. But the child is concerned. Why we are playing with the child? Because he is creating problem, not allowing the mother to cook. You don't find any other place to go. So, when a child and an elderly person, hey, don't come here. Sit down. Good. See, that is a man. So, when we are playing with the child, it is just a time pass. We are not achieving anything. There we are not making it a prestige issue. That I am defeated or I have won the game. No. Then what for? Till he is entertained, food will not be ready. And I will have to eat yesterday's coming out of the fridge, going into the microwave, and directly the pindadan is given. Whenever people give the food from the microwave to me, I always remember that I am a crow. And that pindadan laddu is given to me. Swamiji, take. Alright. Therefore, make life as a time pass. Don't become serious. Things have always been like this. There is nothing new that has ever happened in this world. Nothing new. Many of us have got this funny notion. Never there was a bad time in the history of humanity as it is today. ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता. यू नो दिस प्रिंसिपल आई डिस्कवर्ड मेनी ईयर्स बिफोर. प्लीज सो मेनी ईयर्स बिफोर देर वॉज वन बुक आई रेड ऑन सम स्पिरिचुअल टॉपिक. मस्ट बी अबाउट 40 ईयर्स बिफोर आई रेड. एंड दैट पब्लिकेशन वॉज 1838 पब्लिकेशन. So the papers, you know, you break like that slowly as you read. So first you normally read the preface. So I wrote. And there it was written. Never there was a time more suitable for the spiritual evolution in the history of humanity. 1838. Then another book I happened to read, which was also in the same century, 1895. Similar type of subject. There also in the introduction the same thing. Then another book, 1936, published from Pune. And in that he has made a very good mention. He said, Mahatma Gandhi is going to spoil the future India by introducing the principle of Satyagraha. Everybody will start that and destroy the country. This is really happening. There also he said, the right time for spirituality is today and never before. You take any book published in 2011. Same thing. This is the right time for the spiritual practice and evolution. Why? Because this time is the worst time in the history of humanity. Earlier it was not. Later it will not be. Because earlier we were not. Later we will not be. Whenever we are, that is the worst time. See, look within. This world has always been like this. There is nothing which justifies our becoming disturbed and miserable. Then how do we live? Drama. Go to Bengaluru and learn Karnataka. Natak karo. The more you learn this art of drama, the more life becomes easier. And the mind will start remaining at peace. Now the last point. If we are relationally not disturbed, then nothing in this world can be superior than meditation. Meditation is not sitting like a statue after doing pranayama and simply sitting like a statue. Swamiji, since I have started doing this kriya and that kriya, now I can sit for half an hour. What more I have to do? Nothing. In our India, buffalo sit for 8 hours. Simply sitting in half one posture cannot be the goal of life. Even if you sit for meditation for 2 hours, what about next 22 hours? What about that? We have to live 24 hours in meditation. And that is possible only when these two things are corrected. Possessiveness about the world and relational problems with the people. Correct these two things. See, whatever you have possessions, like I have got a possession of this camera. When this sweet boy comes here, my heart beat start beating. Now this Rakshasa will come and destroy. Because it is mine. If you do the same thing with this screen, no, children do like that. Immediately, I become a philosopher. But when it comes to my camera, I become tragic, you know. So, possessiveness is one. And second thing is relations. See, when the child is mine, anything that he does is wonderful. I have suffered because of this thing from many mothers. One girl in Bombay, they, you know, I went to their house for something. And then, again, same thing, like, you know, no child and all that. Swamiji, we are invited, you are the first Mahatma to come in our house and all that. So I can do natak very well. I said, Amma, take this mango, eat in front of me. So she ate that mango. And by God's grace, she conceived and got the baby. After 6-8 months, she came in the satsang. And last day, so I was sitting on the Vyaspeet, people coming, giving dakshina and namaskar. So she came last. She said, Swamiji, now this is my child. So the child was given to me. I said, Mama, do you know what you have done? I am sitting on the Vyaspeet, people give me here dakshina. You have given me your child as dakshina. Thank you so much. Now I will make a babaji out of you. I said, I didn't ask, you only gave me. And after some time, I said, hey, come on, take him away, dirty fellow, smelling bad. He has done probably. And that time the mother was happy. Swamiji, you are great. Why? 3 days se nahi gaya tha. Last 3 days he has not gone. By your touch he has gone. For the mother, even that is a great event, you know, because it is my child. See, friends, these two things if we correct, possessiveness about the things and the relations with the beings. If these two things are understood properly, life is a fun. These are the fundamentals of life. If fundas are clear, life is a fun. If fundas are not clear, life is mental. Therefore, fundamental. Now decide and live happily hereafter. One small story, a child was asked to write. Write a short story ending in a happy ending, okay? Quickly. So all the students started. One child, madam, done. So early, others are still holding the pen and eating the pen. I have done it. Okay, read it now. You will get the first prize. There was a man and a woman, first sentence. Second. They were standing back to back. Third sentence. They started walking. Four sentences. Thereafter they lived happily. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.